choice. The choice you make that comment. That's a principle. Why is it a principle? Because it applies to everybody.
We talked about honesty last week, and we talked about most people think they're being honest, but they're in denial. Denial means you don't even know you're lying. All right? And honesty is not about what comes out of your mouth. I think I told you that once before, right?
Not what you do.
No, if you believe in some crap that's not true, you're telling yourself a lie. That's what denial means. All right. If you're running around believing things that aren't true, you don't even have to open your mouth. Your behavior shows that you're in denial. See? You don't have to say anything to lie. And if you understand what I'm saying about these different principles and things, what you'll understand is you practice that stuff on yourself. You're the one that's practicing them. When they say practice these principles, they're talking about you practicing them. It's not talking about what you do with other people. It's talking about how you do things. And let me explain what this means. Anybody got any idea what that means?
Like speak for yourself.
What does that mean, personally? You guys have a habit of knowing answers, but you can't say what you do.
You create your own condition.
Yeah, you define your life. Yeah. No, you do it. You define your life based on the choices you make. You understand what I'm saying? And while y'all running around looking for what everything means, you ain't gonna find it. It's what it means to you. Okay? That's how it's a self-defining process. You see what I'm saying? You define who you are. By your behavior and your thinking and your beliefs and your attitude. That tells people who you are. So you're trying to find out who you are. Look at what you do. That's what determines who you are. You're looking for some fixed definition. Your name is just a name. You know, you probably ain't the only one with that name. But it's the way you live your life that defines your life. All right? And that's how you became defined as an addict. Okay? Because of your drug use and all of the behaviors that go along with the doggone drug use, you created that definition of yourself. You think it's coming from outside somewhere. No. Addict defines who you are. That's what it's doing. That's your behavior. That's what you did the most of. That's what you did longer than you did anything else. Regardless of whether you was married, single, had a job, didn't have a job, bad times, good times, what day of the week. One thing that you did throughout all of the changes in life is you got high. Okay? So before you was a husband or a father, or you might have did all them things. All right. But one thing you did consistently, that was get high. And you don't like the term addict. You created it. You did it. A doctor is a doctor because of what he does. There's a scripture saying, by their works ye shall know them. This shit ain't nothing new that I'm saying. It's right there. And you trying to figure out what's wrong with you. You ain't acting right. It's real damn simple. You ain't acting right. You got to do something to get high. You looking up to what's wrong with your thinking. You know, a lot of crazy people run around in the world. You don't get locked up for being crazy. You don't get locked up for being high. You don't get locked up for being addict. You get locked up for the shit you do. It's what you do that determines who you are, not some predetermined idea of who you are. All them things ain't got nothing to do with you. They're just statements. You created the life that you got. It's a self-defining process. What that means is that you define it based on how you live it, based on what you do. That's why I asked that question last week. How much of your identity comes from your relations with other people? With your parents, right? You're their son. With your siblings, you're their brothers. All right. With your wives, you're their husbands. With your employers, you're their employees. Okay. And how many of these things are you? Or are they just things that you do? And you perform a different way in each one of them arenas. But the bottom line is that it's all you. So you really can't put no real definition on you. Your name is just some way to identify you. But it's what you do throughout life that defines who the devil you are. Multifaceted. You could say that. Right? But that's a facet is a fixed thing. It's more like a kaleidoscope. If you know what that thing is. You remember them things you used to look through and you twist it and it changes into all different shapes and stuff? Well, that's what human beings are. You basically can define yourself based on what you do. You know, but that's really not who you are. You're just a human being. That's who you are. Right? Now, you might do some things better than others. Things like that. You got certain talent skills. Everybody got them. But you ain't never looked at none of that because that takes work. And your main focus in life is to feel good. Right? And that's what screwed you up. Because life ain't about feeling fucking good. How many of y'all didn't know that? That's what you thought it was about? What? No, it's not. It's about living and learning. And in order to feel good, you got to learn how to do that. What you learn how to do was take a chemical and feel good rather than put in some work, right? And being able to take pride in your achievements, your accomplishments, things you create, things you do, your behavior, the way you treat people, stuff like that. That's the stuff that makes you feel good that you can do on your own, right? But what you elected to do, most of those things require some self-discipline. Those things require the same principles that it requires you to live in life, right? That's why that 12-step program says practice these principles in all our affairs. Because that's what you got to do across the board. Okay. Y'all think the 12-step program is a stop using drug program. No, it ain't. No, it ain't. I think I told you last week, it's been in existence long before anybody even thought about using any doggone drugs. It's about changing your attitude. Y'all don't even see what your attitude got to do with you getting high, do you? Anybody? What? Attitude. What is attitude?
A feeling.
Huh?
Could be considered a feeling.
It's bigger than a feeling.
Beliefs?
I'd say your personality.
Hell no. No. I don't even know what that is. Personality. What's that? A set of characteristics. That's what a personality structure is, a set of characteristics, you know. It's a combination of your beliefs and your biases and your prejudices and things like that, things that you like and don't like. You understand what I'm saying? And the things you like and you don't like, most of that stuff is learned behavior. Okay, so if it's learned behavior, what that means is that you can change it. You can learn a different kind of behavior. That's a good thing about being human, is that most of the stuff that you do, you picked up and you learned. So if you learned it, that means you can also unlearn it and do something different. You see what I'm saying? And your attitude is based on how you see the world. Okay, what about your attitude about your damn self? Y'all ain't gonna like us. Why do you get so upset when you feel like you've been disrespected? Why do you get so upset when you feel like you've been disrespected? Huh? Well, if you're going around 24/7 disrespecting your damn self, how you think you're supposed to feel? You see where I'm getting at? If you disrespecting yourself as a person, as a human being, why do you think you feel so damn bad? I told you this is stuff you need to practice on yourself. You're not showing yourself any respect. So that's why you got a negative attitude. That's why you see such a negative stuff in the world. You see the world from where you at. You see the world based on your attitude. And if you're not respecting you, how you gonna respect anybody else? How you gonna give away something you ain't got? If you ain't loving and caring you, how you gonna care about anybody else? You're not. And you don't. See, feelings ain't facts. Feelings ain't facts. Because a feeling changes. A fact is a fact. It stays the same. See, feelings change. It's a fact that you feel it, but it's not a fact that the way you feel has anything to do with whatever it is you feel that way about. Because somebody else can see the same thing and feel totally different about it. You see? But the main focus is what the... Yeah. Because it don't belong to you. You ever heard that saying, what you're saying? You ever heard that saying, it's better to give than receive?
Yeah.
Well, what we're talking about, I put this on there last week, didn't I? Law of reciprocity. Remember? Y'all got short memories. Or you don't understand how it operates. In other words, every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So it's by giving that you receive. You understand it now? Yeah. Yeah, yeah, that's what it means. It's by giving that you receive. See, look at the universe, whole universe, as a big bank. All right. Now, what you want, you got to put it in deposit. Otherwise, when you go back to get it, you insufficient funds. You understand what I'm saying? If you don't put no money in the goddamn bank, then you ain't getting none out of there. See, but the reason why your life is so empty and void is because you've been spending your whole time using instead of giving. You see what I'm saying? You ain't put nothing in the world, so how you expect to get something out of it? You ain't got shit coming. That's what I tell you all the time. You know, you ain't got a damn thing coming. That's a damn fairy tale. You got something coming for what? Because you stop using? Okay, now, let me tell you why you got pain coming. Because all that shit you use, you got to square that. That's what we talk about making amends and making up for, and all that shit. See, all that shit you used, you got to square that. And squaring it means you ain't got shit coming. See, now when you start doing some shit with the right kind of attitude, then you'll start getting back what you put in there. But if you look at your life, I mean, you know what we did. I'm going to get mine by any means necessary. Okay, you got yours. Now, they want theirs. You dance to the music, you pay the goddamn piper. And the one who paid the piper called the tune. See, y'all under some illusion that you're doing somebody a damn favor because you ain't getting high. Yeah, you're doing yourself a goddamn favor. For real. You're doing yourself a favor. Keep the focus on you. I think when I talk to you guys, y'all take that shit and think you're supposed to go out there and work it on the world. Look, the world don't give a fuck about you. The world is just there. Feelings and sympathy and compassion and all that shit. That shit don't exist in the world. It exists in people. All right? It exists in people. The world don't feel shit. The world just there. I mean, you look at shit like Katrina and the tsunamis and shit. The world don't give a fuck how many people sitting there. It's going to tear some shit up and everybody going. You dig? So the world ain't responsible for a goddamn thing. The world going to do what it do. It ain't got shit to do with you. See, those things you looking for exist in people. And the only way you're going to get those things from people, right, is to be like that. You see, you can't manipulate this kind of shit. As long as you're doing it for purely selfish reasons, it ain't going to work. What does that thing say the whole reason for working a 12-step program is? Yeah, to help somebody. That's what the fuck you're doing it for. And y'all look at me like you surprised. Well, you probably is, because you was doing it for your goddamn self. That's why the fuck it ain't going to work. And that's why you keep coming in out of these goddamn rehab, because you're just as selfish and self-centered as your ass was when you was on the street. You in a rehab to get your shit together. Well, you got to get your shit together in order to help somebody. But how you know that what you're doing is going to help somebody if you don't practice doing it your damn self? You can't just listen to what I say and go somewhere and say a bunch of goddamn words to impress somebody, because you'll start believing that shit till you put some Jane in you. Then you I don't know what happened. I know what happened. You ain't did shit. You talk some shit, you ain't did a goddamn thing. You got to put in some work as far as this thing is concerned. Now, back to this self-definition thing. I'm going to talk about some shit that y'all don't like for me to fuck with. But relationships. And how you fucked that up. Because I know you fucked it up. I know if you fucked up, you can't do nothing but some fucked up shit. You might have good intentions, but I mean, what the fuck? It didn't come down like that. You know what I'm saying? Addicts' intentions ain't worth a fuck. You know, I ain't going to get no joint today. I'm going in a program next week. I'm going to put this money up. Shit. Most relationships, and both people are at fault, okay? Most relationships are based on each other's weaknesses. Yeah. You get into a relationship based on what you need, right? Ain't that why you get in? based on what you need, right? And that's the same reason why the woman gets into what she needs. See, but it's a bigger picture than that. See, the culture and religion and everything has defined what a relationship is. It's also defined what roles everybody gonna play. So you grow up believing that shit. Right? The woman is raised up and taught from that big how to work a son of a bitch. I'm serious. They taught early on in the game. I ain't lying. From the time they little teeny girls, they taught to find a son of a bitch that's going to take him. Right or wrong?
How's that?
I learned how to work his ass. They know how to stroke a son of a bitch. They know how to push them damn buttons. And they know how to shut that thing down. And what you taught is how to work. You ain't taught none of this other shit. You taught how to get some money so you can take care of her, and she looking for somebody to take care of. Right? So that's the way the shit goes down. Right? Now, you get in a relationship based on some goddamn feelings. All right? But the real shit really don't give a fuck how you feel. It's what you can do. You see? And the way most men see they self, right? Your self-worth and your self-esteem and your integrity, your self-worth is based on your net worth. Now, who understand what I just said? Exactly. You ain't got shit, you ain't shit. And ain't got shit coming. For real. Everybody that comes in treatment, first thing they want to do is stop using, get a goddamn job. Why? Do you realize that you in a treatment program because the shit you're doing might kill you? Mm-hmm. You understand it? Yeah. You damn sure don't understand that. So what the fuck you want with a job? I'm serious. You don't see that. You in this program because you got a brain disease that could kill you if you don't learn how to change your attitude and your behavior. That's how serious the shit is. And you worried about a goddamn job. You had a fucking job. You put it all the money you had in you. You had an old lady. You ain't give a fuck about that. You had a place to stay. Fuck the landlord. Not only landlord, gas and electric, the phone bill, the children, the old lady, fuck everything. I'm going to get high. So then you come in a program and stop getting high and holler about, I need this shit again. That shit ain't stop you from getting high all that damn time, did it? What makes you think it's going to stop you now? I know what you're thinking. This dopey shit. Yeah, well, I learned my lesson. You ain't learned a motherfucking thing. What you need to learn is how to change your attitude and your behavior, and you need to practice that shit over a long period of time as many ways as you fucking can. That's what you in here for, whether you know it or not. You got this microwave recovery. I ain't getting high no more. Now it's time for me to go to school, go to work. You ain't gonna hide behind that shit, because Slewfoot gonna come up wherever the fuck your ass go. I ain't lying. See, it's your disease that's telling you to go do some other kind of shit. See, it wants you to take the focus off of it. So it knows where your other weaknesses are. So it attacks you by having you chase that shit. And you don't even see it. That's how this shit works. It plays you. See, the drugs didn't fuck you up. Honest to God, the drugs, that Slewfoot boy, that's the baddest son of a bitch I ever ran into. I'm going to tell you how bad he is. And I don't know whether you see it or not, why you talk about you got a drug habit and all that. I'm going to tell you something that's really fucked up. The drugs didn't fuck you up. It made you fuck yourself up. You ain't never ran into no shit like that. That's what you up against. It didn't fuck you up. Because drugs, I mean, that shit, I can put a kilo of cocaine over there on that windowsill. If you don't go put it in you, it ain't going to do a goddamn thing. See, you up against some shit, and you've been played. I ain't lying. Because the drugs is playing you. You've been played like a goddamn $2 hoe. The drugs made you fuck yourself up. So who's the problem? You. Not the damn drugs. What is it about you that causes you to do some shit that's going to fuck you up? And if you don't think that's a problem, there's something to fuck wrong with you. Your focus is on events. I'm saying, well, fuck that. Other people do the same shit you do. They don't fuck themselves up in the process. It's something about you that you don't see, that you ain't in touch with, that's directing every goddamn thing you do, and you don't even know it. That's what we mean by denial. That's why we say follow directions. Because directions is somebody else's goddamn thinking. See? That's why we say follow directions. Because your thinking will fuck you up. And I don't mean certain kinds of thinking. I mean your thinking, period. Because what you think, the only goddamn thing you think about, really, I don't give a fuck what it is. The only thing you think about is how it's going to feel. And when feelings is directing your behavior, you ain't seeing shit clear. You're like a goddamn one-eyed cat peeping in the seafood store. I ain't lying. You ain't seeing a goddamn thing. You feeling some shit. And I know I can do it if I can just get to it. And don't know that what you're going to do, going to turn around and do your ass. Because you invited that shit. As long as your feelings is directing what you do, you in active addiction. Ain't the trap that killed the rat, it's his love of the goddamn cheese. You see? And you looking out there in the world as to what you got to avoid and all that kind of shit, you need to look inside you and see what it is in you that's causing, and I told you what it was, chasing a goddamn ghost, a memory of how something felt. Chasing the memory of how some shit felt. Because all you do is go up in your head and find a goddamn drug substitute. Money, property, prestige, pussy, you know. And what the text say, anytime I use anything to change the way I feel, I activate my addiction. That's what it's talking about. And you don't see it. You'll stop the drug use, but you got some kind of shit stashed somewhere that you can hook up with.
Just put away
Well, you got a stash somewhere. You got a whole warehouse full of shit between his motherfucking ears. He'll go and sit down somewhere and dream up a good ass whoop. Your only hope is to follow fucking directions. I'm telling you, I don't know why you got a problem with it. What's the problem with following damn directions? What's the problem?
You ain't used to it. Pride get in the way.
You ain't used to it. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You've been following them all your goddamn life.
Maybe they don't like the outcome.
No, you've been following them all your life. A person come in the world, they don't know how to do a goddamn thing. But the problem is, the directions that we suggest that you follow don't fucking feel good. You try to figure out a way you can do it without being uncomfortable. You try to cop short. See, that's a goddamn dope fiend mentality. I want the payoff, but I don't want to put in a whole lot of goddamn work to get it. See, so that's how you got hooked up with that thing. Oh, you need $10. You can get all right with yourself. Ain't got to put in shit. You see? And anything that's going to last for a while, you got to earn the shit. You dig? You got to earn it. You earn some money, but what the fuck? You blew that. And look how long the feeling lasts, and look how long the consequences last. That is hustling ass backwards. And everybody coming here hollering about hustling. I say, how the fuck you hustle? You took some short-term gain for some long-term pain. You hustling ass backwards. How long did that thing last? And I don't know what the fuck y'all doing. I ain't had nothing for about 20 years. But at least when I was doing that, you know, the shit would hit and hold. I seen you motherfuckers. I seen some bitch go up the street and get himself some jank. You know how you can tell? Because they got that cop walk. You know that. You know that fast walking shit. He trying to hurry up and put that thing in. And motherfucker ain't looking right or left. He looking straight ahead. You know? And he went over there in them damn train tracks down South Baltimore. It's about a block away. That motherfucker went down there in that goddamn hole. About 15 minutes later, they come back. They're going up the street again. I said, damn, man, what y'all doing? Crack? Nah, man, it's jank. I said, jank? The fuck kind of jank is that? You just went the fuck down there and put it in you. That 15-minute shit. What the fuck is that? Flash Gordon shit. Yeah, you know that shit, you put it in and go, damn. And then just that fast, that shit gone. Y'all, what the fuck?
I did wrong.
But needless to say, the things that mean most in life are the stuff you got to earn. You got to put in a lot of work. It has a more lasting value. You tend to look after it more because you done put more effort into getting it, right? So whether it's a relationship, whether it's a job or whatever the devil it is, even whether it's your own life, right? Let's start with that. Your own life. You got to put in some work. That's self-defining, mean you the architect of your life. It ain't on God. God gave life to you. And you can do whatever you want to do with it. For real. You can do whatever you want to do with it. I don't know what makes you think that God running the show. What show you talking about? When y'all say that, well, what you talking about? What show God's supposed to be running? Hmm? I think God got more sense than most people. And if you look at the world, ain't no way God running no shit like that. I mean, for real, y'all, I don't know what kind of God y'all dealing with, but ain't no way God running some shit like this shit y'all fucking with. I'm serious. You know, that's taking God's name in vain. Y'all need to check that, because that's a goddamn shame to lay some shit like this on God. I'm serious. I don't understand what kind of damn thinking y'all be doing if you think some shit like that. That's what I mean when I say your thinking ain't correct. Because if you believe God got all his power and all of that, ain't no way he would fuck nothing up like y'all do. For real. This is all your shit. Every goddamn bit of it. Now you sit there and wait the fuck for somebody to square it up for you, yeah? I ain't lying. Y'all, you know, I used to believe that shit. I ain't lying. I used to believe that shit. Old wino named Will put me down. Shit. Me and Will sitting up on Fed Street, we done run out of dope money and coke money and all that shit. We drinking Midnight Berry. And we had one of these little, you know, them little goddamn stoves that get red hot around the motherfucker. And you got to get just the right distance. Because if you get too close, it's going to burn your shit up. If you get too far away, you ain't going to get none of that heat. So we sitting around this damn stove, and I had just went and got another fifth of that wine and shit. And we sitting there drinking, and you know how when you get half fucked up in the head, you start talking all this philosophy and shit? Like you're so goddamn profound and deep, and you drunk than a motherfucker. You know, the shit you saying ain't making no goddamn sense to nobody but you. You know, me and Will sitting there talking, I'm telling him, I say, yeah, Will, man, I don't know, I'm going to have to cut this shit out. Say, I done prayed and I done asked God to help me, and all I ain't nothing happened. Old man Will took another sip of that goddamn wine, told me, say, man, God ain't suffering, your ass is. That was the realest shit I ever. He broke me off, boy, and put that shit right where I needed it to be. And took all that other shit off the table, see. Addicts have a habit of blaming something or somebody for the self-depriving process that they done engaged in. You understand what I'm saying? You are the one who created the damn circumstances that you experienced. How'd you create them? By the choices you made and by the attitude that you got. That's how you did it. That's why they say in the thing that recovery is a conscious change in ideas, thinking, and attitude. Y'all talk about recovery and say, yeah, I'm in recovery now. I got me a job. I got more. That ain't got shit to do with recovery. That ain't got nothing to do with recovery. Recovery is an inside job. It'll show up on the outside, but the damn process starts on the inside. You got to work on shit that you ain't even seeing. That's what I'm saying about you being in denial. You going out and rearrange the goddamn world and then sit down and be comfortable. That's like rearranging deck chairs on the motherfucking Titanic. The shit going down any goddamn way. I don't give a fuck where you sitting. You see? So what you need to rearrange is the way you process information. And look, the simplest way is to follow fucking directions. Because everything you trying to figure out already been figured the fuck out. You trying to reinvent the goddamn wheel. I'm trying to figure this shit out. What for? People have already figured it out a couple thousand motherfucking years ago. Where the fuck you been? And here you come. I want to tell my story. Shit. I don't feel like hearing that shit. Your story is the same as everybody else. You put some of that shit in you, you liked it, and you kept the fuck on doing it. And you got your ass turned out as a result of it. And now you're looking for a reason. I tell you what, you like that shit. That's the reason. Now, the question is, why do you like it? Because it feel good. Remember I said feelings ain't facts? It feel good, but since every action, that law of reciprocity, every action has an equal and opposite reaction, what did that tell you about what the fuck ever it is that feel good? What's the opposite reaction going to be?
Pain.
Mm-hmm. See, pleasure and pain is the same shit. I don't know whether you see it or not. Pain is the absence of pleasure, and pleasure is the absence of pain. You can't have one without the goddamn other. See, so what you have to learn how to do is work somewhere in there. You understand what I'm saying? The Buddhists call this the middle path. Somewhere between pleasure and pain lies that shit, that serenity. I ain't feel no pain. I ain't feel no pleasure. I'm all right. See, now the minute, yeah, for real. In the 12-step program, they call this shit tolerance. Right? How much you can stand. That's what tolerance means, right? How much you can stand. Okay? So if you split, if you try to stay in between, you ain't have to worry about going either way. But see, either side of it is like goddamn seesaw. See? Like I said, pain is the absence of pleasure, and pleasure is the absence of pain. But I don't think you see that. You only see half of some shit. That's what I meant about a one-eyed motherfucking cat. See, you only see half of the shit. You got two goddamn eyes. What they're trying to tell you, that everything got a head, got an ass. But you get all caught up in this shit and think you going to lay up in your... No. All you doing is building up a ass whooping. Because you damn sure can't have one without the other. See, so you try to stay somewhere in moderation. You take what you need and let the rest go. You see? But if it's pleasure, you want all of it. And that sets you up for all... This shit got to balance itself out. Right? It's got to balance out. So all of that fun you had, getting high and shit, lying and shit, partying and shit, tricking and shit, all that goddamn fun you had, right? Now the thing got to balance itself out. That's all it is to it. That's what I mean about that pleasure shit. I told y'all how I get down. Everything I like is suspect. Every goddamn thing I like is suspect. I don't give a fuck what it is. Because I know me. See, and if I look at my history and get honest, it was the shit that I liked that fucked me up. For real. If you don't see that, you're blind. The shit that I didn't like, I didn't fuck with. Right? It was the shit that I liked that fucked me up. But somehow, y'all stop using drugs and go right back to wanting to do what you like. All over again. Missing the whole damn point. Y'all not seeing this shit. You're not being honest and you're not processing it. You see, it was the shit that you liked that put you in all these damn jackpots. The drugs, the liquor, the broads, the money. That's what caused your problems. The shit you liked, the shit you didn't like, you ain't fuck with. Job, fuck that. Quit a goddamn job, go get high. Old lady ain't acting right, fuck it, I get high. So it's the shit that you like that you need to be on the alert about. You need to shut that shit down for a while. That's why we do that shit in these programs. You know, y'all talk about, damn, this is, I don't like it. I said, good. You ain't supposed to like it. This ain't motherfucking Club Med. You know, it's a rehab and it's a place where you come to get yourself together. Hopefully to learn some new behaviors, develop a new attitude. You got enough people in you to practice your principles. Because, you know, them principles that tell you about being honest and all that kind of shit. But most of the people that I see in all these programs, they in the song bitch bitten. They're carrying the same attitude in the program they carry when they is in stir. You know, walking around, mogul broke down, all kind of shit, ain't learned the motherfucking thing. Doing some damn time, get drugs up off of them, go back, do same shit all over again. And if the shit didn't work the first time, what makes you think that it's going to work now? The world ain't going to change. Everything that you know, everything that you used to, still going to be where it's at. The only thing about it is you need to change your attitude about it. Okay, what's your attitude about that shit? That's your attitude. How do I know? Listen to the stories. You don't know you're telling it. When you say so-and-so did such-and-such, and that's what caused you to get high, and I'm saying, nah, that ain't what caused you to get high. It's your being dependent on that person to act a certain way, and when they didn't, that's why you got high. It's your dependency that caused all this shit. Believe it or not, it's your dependency that caused all your goddamn problems. You outsourced every damn need that you got. You outsourced it. You made the women responsible for your goddamn feelings. You made the employees responsible for you getting any money. And you ain't the only ones. That's just the way people are. Most people are dependent. I ain't lying. Look at them damn people that work for General Motors and all them places and had their pension and their life and their retirement and everything all tied up in some goddamn people up on Wall Street. And then when the big goddamn thing hit and everybody got laid the fuck off and ain't nobody got shit coming, they blame the Wall Street bankers. They fucked our money up. I say, you gave it to them. You fucking gave it to them. Everybody can't do it. Okay, everybody can't do it. Everybody can do it, but they choose not to because of some hard-ass work. You got to get yourself in one of them damn positions where you can take care of you. For real. Where you can take care of you, and you're going to have to learn how to depend on your damn self. And the best way I know it is by practicing them damn principles. See, because that will allow other people to trust you, to help you out, to do things for you, to give you work, get in relationships with you. That's what you need to do. You need to learn to practice them things in all your doggone affairs, because if you don't, you're going to have a hard-ass time. See, what you've been doing is learning how to say what you think people want to hear, tell a damn lie, be a con man, cop for nothing, cop in short, all kinds of shit like that, promising a whole lot of stuff that you ain't really going to do. Then when it all comes to a damn head, you find up you done wasted your damn time, because now don't nobody want to fuck with you, and you ain't got shit nowhere coming. That's what the addiction did. That's what your dependency did. It ain't the drugs. The drugs is chemical dependency. You was dependent and doing all of the shit that led up to the drug use long before you even put the damn drugs in you. See? And that's your blind spot. See? You start with the damn drug use and what went along with that. I'm saying you were dependent long before you even put the drugs in you. Then when the people, places, and things didn't do what you expected them to do for you, then you turn to the drugs. So to just stop the drug use and don't deal with this shit here, you're going to wind up right back on the drugs all over again. That's why we tell you sit still. That's why we say don't do this and don't do that. Because what you need to do is learn how to get all right with yourself without using any goddamn thing. And what you're going through being in these programs is withdrawal. Not from the drugs. No, withdrawal from all that other shit you're dependent on. Because once you become dependent, the only way to break the dependency is to go through withdrawal. And that's a very uncomfortable process. But the only way you're going to break the dependency is to go through withdrawal. You see? And I'm not talking about drug withdrawal. I'm talking about your dependency on people, places, and things. Do you understand what I'm saying? So the drug use is just the tip of the iceberg. Like the text say, the drug use is just a symptom of the damn problem. They call it addiction. I'm saying it's dependency. The dependency caused the addiction. Not that the addiction caused the dependency. You weren't able to take care of yourself by yourself before you started using drugs. Think about it. That's what you use people, places, and things for. To look out for you, to be there for you, to take care of you when you need it and shit like that. Right? So you were dependent long before you even put the damn drugs in you. So now the drug's gone. What are you going to do about this? And how do you work this relationship bit if y'all get into a relationship based on weakness? based on what you need. Ain't that why you get in a relationship? How many of y'all get in a relationship because you feel like you got a lot to offer? Damn, ain't nobody raising motherfucking hand. What you mean you ain't got nothing to offer? Why not? How much do it cost to be honest? How much do it cost to care about somebody? How much do it cost to show some compassion, some understanding, some courage? Okay, so what you mean you ain't got nothing? No, I'm not talking about that. See, that's what I mean by denial. That's what I mean by low self-esteem and lack of confidence. Because everything, like I said at first, you equate your self-worth with your net worth. So if you ain't got shit, you ain't shit. What about what you got? You never use that? That don't cost shit. That's what people looking for. That's what the fuck you looking for. That's what you've been looking for. That's what you've been looking for. And you didn't even fucking know it. Maybe you don't think you deserve any of that shit. You probably don't because you ain't ever put none out there. You try to cop by spending some goddamn money or buying some shit. And that way, you ain't getting no real shit. You know, that's manipulation. You ain't getting nothing real. You can get a trick any goddamn way for spending some motherfucking money. That's why you're so goddamn insecure, because you know that she ain't into you for no motherfucking shit that you doing. She into you for what you can do for her. And the only thing you can do for her, like you say, is spend some goddamn money. What about those human qualities that most people need? You know? Most goddamn women, don't shake your head, man, because you ain't even practiced this shit. You out there talking shit. Most goddamn people, most addicts I know, that's where they at. They don't know how to do that kind of shit. They just don't know how to do it. That's why you got to practice it. You got to practice being nice to people. You got to practice. Most women, I'm going to tell you something, and this is a phenomenon, and I hope I ain't stepping on no toes, but usually I do because this is what happens. You got a woman and you spending all this goddamn money and giving her everything that she want and all this kind of shit, and you ain't ever there because you grinding. And you spending money and buying her this and buying her that, and then here comes some poor broke ass son bitch ain't got shit, and he laying in the hind parts like I don't know what. And you hollering about, damn, what the fuck she want with him? He ain't got shit. You ever notice that shit? That's what happened. You working somewhere and Jody, he want a sandwich. You know what I'm saying? All he wants is a sandwich. And she give him a sandwich and he thanks her and smiles and tell her he don't know what he would do without her and how nice and kind she is and shit. You see what I'm saying? See, it's within a woman's nature to nurture. That's what they do. Right? But if you all right all the goddamn time, you don't need shit. You see? If you all right all the time, you got a pocket full of money, you got this, you got that, you got the other, you don't need a goddamn thing. You telling us shit, all, you know, I don't need her. I'm just paying her some money and you know. What about how you feel? You can't even fucking talk about that because you think feelings is for bitches. For real. You think if you got feelings, it make you some kind of bitch. So you never learn how to do that. Of course, you don't have no vulnerabilities. You got this. You know how Dauphine is. He's sitting around on a goddamn corner, dog, dirty and sick. And every other goddamn thing ain't 8, 4, 5 days had the same shit on him. For God knows how long. What's up, Jack, man? I'm high in a motherfucker. He all right. Looking like that. Even in that kind of shit, he won't ask for no help. Pride. Done killed more goddamn addicts than drugs ever did. Got too much pride to say I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Got too much pride to tell a goddamn woman I need some of that, you know, that TLC you got? You break off a little something, and that's where you get it. That ain't loving. That's tricking. That's all fuck that is. She go get a loving from some needy son bitch out there that really need it. You know, she might even take some of that money you giving her and buy them pair of shoes and shit. Then you ready to kill her. This took all my goddamn money. I done heard that shit 1,000 times. I done heard it, motherfucker. 90% of motherfuckers in jail, some woman done fucked over. I'm saying, how'd she fuck over? Took my goddamn money and shit. I say, man, look, you need to give her what she need. You know, the money is one thing, but women need a little, you know, they need to know you care about them. But addicts don't know how to care about nobody. Why is that? Because they don't care about the goddamn self. So they don't know what being nice to their damn self means. They don't know how treating themselves with some kindness and some consideration and some respect. They don't know about no shit like that. So if you don't know how to do that for your damn self, how are you going to do it for somebody else? And see, the shit I'm talking about, you don't need no goddamn money. Money easy. Go out, take some, stick somebody up, or get a job. You get some money. What about that other shit? The shit I'm talking about. That shit inside you that you.
It's hard to bring in.
Huh?
It's hard to bring in.
Why? Because you don't know how to do it.
Because we ain't used to doing it.
Well, that's what you need to practice. That's what those principles are. Y'all still in here trying to cop short. I get me some money, I get me a woman. Yeah, you damn sure will. You damn sure will, because they some money-macking motherfuckers. I ain't lying. Them broads taught how to money-mack from the time they that damn big. You know what I'm saying? Know how to be nice and smile and everything else. You know? And then sit back, yeah, that's my old. I say, yeah, I know. The thing I'm trying to say to you guys, real simple, and this is some hard shit. Y'all think that memorizing a whole lot of words out of the book and all this kind of shit is hard. You got to do something harder than that. What you say, man? You got to go in there and that shit that you got in you that you ain't even aware that's in there because you don't know how to fucking do it. Right? You got to practice that kind of shit. See? But I know why you don't want to do that, see, because you motherfucking gangster. see, that's that other shit y'all hide behind there. Y'all don't know nothing about kindness and loving and caring and consideration, because you goddamn gangster. You know, you one of them Bogarten kind of motherfuckers. I know you ain't got no feelings or no shit like that. You know, you're a soldier, right? Ain't that what this shit is? You motherfucking soldier. Fighting the whole motherfucking world. You know? One thing that soldiers do, most, I don't know whether y'all ever been in the military. If you had, you wouldn't call yourself a soldier. Because a good soldier follows directions. That's what makes a good soldier. He follows orders. He don't question them. He don't analyze them. He don't say nothing. They tell him to do something, he go ahead and do it. That's what a soldier does. Now, y'all done put this soldier thing in some other kind of context. The way I hear you talking about being a soldier is you can take years and years and years of ass whooping. See, that ain't no goddamn soldier. And that's being a goddamn fool. You know, the same ass whipping over and over and over and over and over again. And looking out there in the world for the reason why. I told you, this thing you got didn't fuck you up. It made you fuck yourself up. If you don't remember nothing else I said, process that shit. And tell me if I'm lying. And I don't think you seen it. How about he got a drug problem? I say, who got the problem? You. And that's what the problem is. You. It ain't drugs. If drugs was the problem, how come everybody ain't fucked up? How come only certain people? Process what I said. Drugs ain't the problem. You the problem. And what's the problem? Your ideas and your attitude. Because the text says the same damn thing. It says there's only one thing that will defeat us in recovery. It's an attitude of intolerance or indifference towards spiritual principles. And I got as many different stories as I got people, but all of it comes from the same goddamn thing. So it's a real simple program, but it ain't fucking easy. And being addicts, you're looking for an easy way to do some of the hardest shit you ever gonna have to do in your life. I swear, this is the hardest shit you ever gonna have to do. Why? Because you have to do it the rest of your goddamn life. You don't do it 40 hours a motherfucking week. You know how this thing is. You will dream about getting fucking high. You laying there asleep, ain't doing shit. And that thing will put a dream on you. Wake up sweating like a motherfucker. So if you think it's a time when your addiction ain't active, what the text say, it always resurfaces? What always mean? So the best thing you can do is have a lifestyle that's pretty consistent all the time. And the lifestyle will not allow drugs to interfere with your well-being. That's the way the game played. Not go learn some shit out of a book or go to a meeting. They tools that you use. But you have to develop a lifestyle where using drugs ain't even considered to be part of it. And that's when you're in recovery. So you need to practice that shit on a daily damn basis till you get good at it. And after you practice it long enough, it becomes second nature, like tying your damn shoes or riding a bicycle. And you ain't gonna learn that in no 28 goddamn days. And they don't teach this shit in school, and they don't teach it on no fucking job, and they don't teach it in no damn relationship. All right? So if you think you're going to one of them and get fixed, I got news for your ass. You're going in one of them and get high. Trust me. We done, Chris?